While the weather this week has been highly unpredictable, it's great to have at least one thing you can count on. Here's another great episode of The Ekko.
Welcome back to The Ekko on this Friday, the 8th of April. I'm Hope Davis, and this is the second show of 2022. Last week, we mentioned our show choirs wrapping up their season. Nevertheless, the sound of music continues.
Several of HHS's very own band and orchestra students spent their spring break doing what they know best. After performing their show in the auditorium for an eager audience, these students flew to California to perform again. Their set consisted of familiar hits from several different movie soundtracks and represented the talent we have from miles and miles away. In order for students such as our musicians to excel, we need great teachers to help guide them. And while it's not uncommon for students who may be in our high school right now to later become those guiding teachers, it's less common for them to go on to teach at the very same school they graduated from. Here's The Ekko's Joe Schuster with the story.
Hey, so take out that.
Another class has begun here in B218 at HHS. The owner of the room is Mr. Schultz, and as it turns out, he's a former student here at the high school.
I graduated in the class of 2011.
And if you think that Mr. Schultz is the only teacher that was a former student, you'd be wrong. With that said, there must be something special about Hastings High School.
The community of Hastings High School, including the students, teachers, the administrators, right, the principals, even like the custodians and lunch ladies, right, have always been so friendly and welcoming, I thought, and really teach you through kind of different forms, right, how to navigate the world, right?
Mr. Schultz may be a new teacher, but he's still a familiar face. For those that don't know, he teaches two subjects here.
I'm a ninth grade civics teacher here at the high school, and then I also teach 12th grade law.
Since he graduated recently, some of his former teachers are now coworkers. One in particular is Mr. Strain.
And he hasn't changed one bit from the first time I had him in a math class to today when I have the pleasure of working with him as a colleague.
And it was Mr. Strain that brought him back here to Hastings.
That friendship kind of ultimately led to the opportunity to come coach.
As great as this school is, Mr. Schultz had some concerns about coming back to teach.
It's surreal, and I had to take a little time after college.
During that time, Mr. Schultz did things that he enjoyed.
For a while, I was really traveling a lot. I lived in Spain a couple of times, so I had a good amount of international travel, and that was like a really like addicting, fun thing to do.
His other hobby involved a musical touch.
I really enjoy like music, like I enjoy going to concerts. I play the guitar.
And eventually, he got to combine the two by performing in Spain. As loved as Mr. Schultz is.
Schultz is our favorite teacher, without a doubt.
He's not really a full-time teacher yet.
Started out subbing for Mr. Harp last year.
And this year, he took over Mrs. Meyer's old room. And I think it's safe to say, he fell in love with the job.
No.
Some jobs maybe don't have as much kind of diversity throughout their day, right?
Mr. Schultz's favorite part is the social aspect.
You try to find bridges to connect with students and young people so that you can make their experience as positive as possible.
With a job opening in the social studies department.
Hopefully we'll kill it in the interview and hopefully make a strong enough impression currently right now with the students that I am teaching that they'll keep me around and I can be here for the long haul.
We'll be hoping to see Mr. Schultz around for many years to come. I'm Joe Schuster, reporting for The Ekko.
We hope Mr. Schultz's career here at HHS is just beginning. Speaking of beginnings, for many athletes, the end of their senior season is the end of their athletic career. But for a few of our athletes, senior year is just the beginning. Teeing off the story for us is The Ekko's Molly Gatke.
Some athletes celebrate huge milestones in high school.
And gets it in there. She's now the eighth Raiders girl basketball player and in school history to have 1,000 career points. Jensen setting two pool records for the Hastings Raiders in his final night here.
And many of these athletes take their skills to the next level.
I will be playing D1 soccer at University of St. Thomas.
I am going to Bemidji State University. I'm going to play baseball next year.
Bella Meyer and Jackson Schaefer are two of the many seniors at HHS that have committed to play their sports in college.
I mean, any level of college soccer I was fine with, but I have the opportunity to play D1, which is super amazing, and I'm really grateful for it.
And with a higher level of play,
I had to fight and compete, get bigger, stronger, faster.
Come greater requirements.
I didn't really have the physical structure from a lot of the guys who are 6'2", 6'3", so I kind of had to grind a little bit more than others.
Jackson stresses the importance of physical training.
Some guys like to wait until practice starts, but I'm kind of the guy who thinks about that game from 8 a.m. until game time.
And his efforts haven't gone unnoticed.
He's just a hard worker. After practice, he'll stay after, take ground balls.
But while Jackson spends time preparing physically, others are forced to work mentally.
I kind of just ran, and then my knee went one way and I went the other, and then I just heard a pop.
Earlier this year, Bella tore her ACL.
I have a 6 to 9 months recovery, so that will go into my preseason of soccer. So I'm scared for that just because I don't know where that's gonna go and I don't know when I'm gonna come back.
But she still does all she can to get ready for college.
It might not be in the same way like lifting and stuff to get stronger or running fitness tests.
I think the greatest opportunity though for a physically injured athlete is to focus on the mental part of it.
Athletic director Trent Hansen knows that physical skill isn't the only quality a good athlete has.
So when you have a strong academic base, when you have high character and integrity, when people can vouch for your work ethic and your commitment, things like that, for a kid like that, it's totally part of the whole package that makes you an attractive prospective athlete for a school for sure.
So whether it's on the field or off, being well-rounded and a good sport is the key to success. Reporting for The Ekko, I'm Molly Gatke.
Congrats to all of our senior athletes for their hard work and accomplishments. You can catch some of those athletes in action tomorrow as our Raiders baseball team opens their season at Park High School. The first pitch is at 1 p.m. Just as these amazing opportunities have arisen for our seniors to play collegiate sports, other amazing opportunities are also happening. Just last Thursday, a real court trial took place in the lecture hall. Right across the bridge, a trial was held in association with the Dakota County Courts.
Well, it's be as if they went to a real court because one of the Dakota County judges will be here today and they are going to be overseeing it.
This allowed students to act on a jury and see how our judicial process works.
I know that so many people are involved in like youth and government and like Model UN. I think they should come and like be a part of it. That's a really cool experience.
This was the second peer court trial to happen this year at our school. If you're interested in being involved in the jury for the next one, keep your eyes on the announcements or contact Mr. Peterson for more information. In other exciting student news, AVID classes recently participated in an event called the AVID Olympics. These Olympics involve the students competing against each other in activities such as card stacking, golfing, and even crab walking. We were lucky enough to be able to be a part of their award ceremony in which the winners for each game were revealed. AVID truly is a class in which students can thrive and express themselves. Another great way for students to express themselves is through after-school activities and clubs. And a new club has recently made its way to HHS focused on all things reading. The Unbook Club is open to anyone who wants to hang out with others and chat about whatever book they're reading. It takes place in the Media Center, of course, and meets next on Thursday, April 21st, right after school. Contact Senior Lily Ordery or Club Advisor Mrs. Hyder if you're interested. Our final story today is guaranteed to take you up, up, and away. The Ekko's Haley Gildes was able to catch a ride recently with one student who has taken his passion for aviation to new heights. Here's her report.
Some see airplanes as an easy paper toy you make when you're bored in class, or a vessel to transport you on vacation. But this senior sees it,
it's kind of like a family thing,
as a career. HHS senior Tommy Siebenaller began his journey in getting his private pilot's license last summer.
Didn't like really always want to, but like this summer my dad just told me to go take a lesson. And when I did, I thought it was really fun, and so I just kept and stuck with it.
Tommy dedicated his entire summer at Lake Elmo Aero to pursuing his newfound dream.
It took me all summer and then up until like November of 2021.
The licensing process is anything but an easy flight.
You gotta be like 17 years old. You have to have 40 in-flight hours, and then you have to have some ground training too. You have to pass a written test, and then you have to go and pass a check ride as well.
Staying motivated was difficult for Tommy, but it has proven to pay off.
I wanted to do other things like golf and hang out with my friends. My dad was just like riding me to like, hey, you gotta go do this. You gotta go fly. You gotta keep doing this.
His dad, Thomas Siebenaller Sr., set the precedent for aviation.
About it, like, since I was a little kid, I mean, with like my uncle flying too, it's kind of like at family, like get-togethers, that's all they would talk about is like flying. So it's kind of been like ingrained in my skull since I was a little kid.
The most exhilarating part, of course, is getting in the air.
You can fly solo, like after, like once your signer instructs you off is safe, but that's only as like with you in the plane, you can't take a passenger because you're a student pilot.
And we got to do just that. Beginning our journey at the training school, Tommy flew us over the places we call home.
Like going up and flying around, it's just, I find it really interesting and fun. It's pretty cool.
Although Tommy kept us flying smooth, not all of his flights have been this nice.
Coming back from my check ride, it was like, I just like flew, I was tired, it was like 6 hours long. And when I was like coming back, the clouds were coming in, like slowly coming down, like lower to the ground, the wind was picking up, so I kind of like rush home, and it's kind of crazy.
This fall, Tommy will continue his aviation career at Mankato State University.
No, I want to fly for like one of like the big airlines like Delta, United.
To follow in his father's footsteps. This was Haley Gildes reporting for The Ekko.
That was just plain awesome. So the next time you see an airplane flying over our school, make sure to wave to Tommy. Hey, it's time for us to catch a flight out of here. I'm Hope Davis. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great weekend. We'll see you next week on The Ekko.
Well, I started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone. And the sun went down as I crossed the hill. And the town lit up. The world gets still. I'm learning.